Hello everyone. I joined TIIM classes in the month of January and I took weekend batches which were classes of 4 hours on Saturday as well as Sunday. Attending classes is important because you get to know the niche things that professors tell you, the tips and tricks of how to do calculations fast and the concepts, etc. I attended almost all lectures unless it was unfeasible to do so. I was working along with, and therefore I did not study when I had joined classes, but I made sure that whatever I studied in class, I used to understand, and I used to ask doubts on the spot rather than waiting for later. I started preparing for CAT full-fledged when I took a break from office as a study leave, and that was 3 months in advance. In the first month, I started strengthening on my basic concepts because CAT is not that it's out of a syllabus book, that these are the sums and that is what will come in the exam. It's more important to strengthen your concepts, your formulae, the tips and tricks of doing calculations faster, knowing the different type of sums rather than just by hearting anything. It's it's an aptitude test, not a normal exam. There can be cases when I was not sure whether I was going right in terms of preparation because time is running out and I'm not sure of whether this is how I should go, this is what I should be doing. So professors are always there to help. I used to go and ask them that this is what I'm planning to do, this is my strategy. I plan to finish these books, the basic books, by 1 month or so, 2 months. And then I plan to do advanced books, but I'm not getting comfortable with this chapter. Can I leave it? Some things like that. It's important to list down what you want to do, plan and strategize whatever you want to do. And I started with the basic books because that involves your basic fundamental concepts, especially for quants. There's your basic book of 801, which involves your basic chapters, and that forms your core strength. I especially wanted to strengthen these because these are the chapters that are basic to all other chapters also. So I did that. For LR, your type of sums are important because you may know, like, there is no fixed portion for LR, it's logical reasoning, so they can ask you anything and there is no thing like this is what is going to come. So doing more sets is more important than doing the same set again and again. For verbal, I focused more on the video solutions and the AIMCAT problems because that gives you a hang of how is it that a paragraph is to be read, a passage is to be read, and how do you answer the questions. How I went about for the three subjects is for quant, I focused more on the basic material that is given by the classes, especially those chapters which are around 8 to 10 chapters which form the basic of your other chapters, simple interest, compound interest, your ratio proportion, geometry is important. So I focused on these chapters. For LRDI, I went through more sets in terms of type of sums rather than doing the same set again and again, so that I get a hang of the different variety that can be asked in the exam. For verbal, I studied through the Word Power Made Easy book through Norman Lewis, and I also went through the video solutions of AIMCATs because looking at the video solutions, I used to understand how to read a passage and how to answer the questions and what strategies can be applied. AIMCATs started in the month of January only, and I had just joined classes when the AIMCATs had started. I was recommended to give AIMCATs irrespective of the level of study because you can never be prepared for CAT entirely. So I used to give all my AIMCATs. I just missed one probably, and it is important to do it because what I felt was that every AIMCAT that I give, I could strategize different approaches and then see what works best for me in terms of time management, in terms of attempting problems, in terms of going through each section and formulating how I should go about with the section because it's timed approach. Another thing I did was analysis of the AIMCATs that I give. I felt it was important to do because once you've given the paper, you forget about it. So when you go back to the analysis, you understand, okay, this is where I made a mistake. So I used to focus on that, and I used to note down the important problems that I came across in AIMCAT in a formula book. So I had one section where I used to write all the formulae down so that I can refer it at the last moment, just time before CAT. And one section was the important problems that I came across that were unique in nature, so that it is a one-off case, and I may not come across this again. So I used to write it down. Writing helped me in two ways. One, I understood the problem more better rather than just listening to the video solution, and I could refer it whenever I wanted. So there was one book that I maintained separately apart from the class notes that I made when I attended the classes. Another thing important that I did was for verbal, listening to video lectures. Because it really helped me to understand how to go about the section, because there are multiple things. There are inference based questions, there are conclusion questions. So how to differentiate, how to eliminate options is very important, because the options are really close. So I used to understand from the professor's explanations on how is this option to be eliminated. Days before CAT, I referred to the formula book and the AIMCATs that were there in the end, because the last AIMCATs were very comprehensive and more closer to the CAT exam the way it appears. Once the CAT exam results were out and I had got my calls from various colleges, I first noted down what are the different procedures each college that has shortlisted me has got, and accordingly I attended the workshops for GD, for case discussions, your VAT, that is written aptitude test, and mock interviews. I had attended all time workshops in respect of mock interviews, case discussions, and your VAT. I used to go through newspapers every day, and also on the topics that were latest news, read more about them in detail, go through different articles, different opinions, so that you can form your own opinion. Because what is asked in any interview is, what do you think about this topic, and not what is the topic. So forming your opinion on different current affairs is what I did. Also, I had registered for colleges that I did not intend to go, because attending a mock interview is one thing, but also giving a live interview is another. The stress is a different perspective, and therefore I wanted to go through that process. Before my actual interviews for the colleges I intended to join, I had already given two or three proper interviews, the original ones. And mock interviews helped me in understanding what is my strength, what is my weakness, what I should know in depth based upon my background and everything. Also, I did revise my academics, because the basics are asked in interviews. Regarding VAT, current affairs is important, and I had read newspapers, and also the topics that are given by professors, I used to understand the topic and also understand what is to be the way your structure of VAT should be. Because when in an actual VAT, you have only say 30 minutes or 20 minutes to from the entire process of getting the topic, thinking and writing. So you should be mentally prepared on how to go about it. That was what I did. Before my actual interviews, I had made a book of all the current affairs topics I referred to, or the basic points that you know, the numbers, the figures, the percentages, and also regarding something very generic on the entire list of ministers that we have currently, because that can be asked randomly. So I did that also. The basic topics and the niche points that I made, I used to refer that before interviews. And before interviews, it is what I used to do is that I used to not read anything, say 2 hours before the interview, because it is important to just calm down and maintain your cool, because sometimes the interviews are just stress interviews, so they are judging you on how you respond and rather not the content of what you respond. So I was told specifically to do this, and I did that, and it really helped.